Hey everyone, it's Lisa from the blog farmhouseonboone.com, and today I want to show you how to make some super easy diaper inserts for cloth diapers. So I shared in a video, gosh, it was probably a year ago or more, whenever Micah was younger, my cloth diaper stash and my favorite cloth diapers that I own. And I mentioned that I like to make my own inserts out of organic hemp fleece because it's super absorbent and they're just so easy to make that you can save a lot of money if you want to make a bunch of them at once. So today I'm finally going to show you how to do that. I kind of briefly mentioned how I do it, but I'm going to actually show you. So first of all, just so you don't have to visit that video, or you can, whatever. My favorite system, the only system to me that actually works well enough to not have to change the baby constantly, is by doing just a diaper cover with an insert on top. That way you can double them up for the baby's needs or if it's overnight, and they come in different sizes. So I'll link the ones that I absolutely love below. I have two here in the regular standard size and I have a newborn size. So I'm gonna show you how to make these inserts in each size. Now I have my serger and my sewing machine out. You can just use a sewing machine if that's all you have. Totally fine. A serger does make the process a little bit easier and the diapers less likely to fray, but don't be discouraged. You can definitely use a sewing machine. So I have here some organic hemp fleece by the yard. This is a hemp cotton fleece blend. And then I have some micro fleece. Now, the micro fleece is optional. You don't have to use it. The reason I like to use it is it has that stay dry effect. So the moisture when the baby wets goes down into the absorbent layer, which here is the hemp fleece, is very absorbent, and it doesn't soak into the micro fleece. So the micro fleece kind of allows the baby to feel dry. The moisture goes down into the absorbent layers, and then the top feels a little bit drier. I got that idea from some diaper inserts that I'd already purchased. Another reason that I'm gonna be putting the micro fleece on top is because over time this hemp material tends to get a little bit scratchy and hard, but the top micro fleece layer does stay soft, so it'll just provide for a comfortable diaper longer. You could, of course, make diapers exclusively from the organic hemp cotton fleece. This is just my preference, and I would do a couple more layers if you're gonna do it that way. This is just a diaper insert that I've had made from these materials from a long time ago. It's been through several babies, but it is getting pretty scratchy here on the bottom, but the top is still nice and soft. Also, I found the best price that I could find for hemp cotton fleece. I will leave a link for that in the description below. They really only have it on select websites. It's not something that I could find. I did used to buy it on Amazon, but then they discontinued it, so I have a new source and I'll link that below. One key to remember is you are going to want to wash and dry both of these fabrics before getting started because they shrink at different rates. So the hemp shrinks a little bit more than the micro fleece, and I find that if you put them together and then wash and dry it, it ends up to where there's a layer of microfleece on top that's kind of bubbly because it's larger. Not a deal breaker, but it is best and advised to wash and dry both of the fabrics first. Some of my favorite diaper inserts are made with this setup. So I usually do two or three layers of the absorbent layer and then a layer on top of the microfleece. Now you can visit the blog for the exact sizes. I have a small, medium, and large size. The small would be great for the newborn diapers. The medium is what I would make the most of because that's what you're gonna use the most, and you could just use that really. And then the large, which is for whenever the diapers are on the fully extended setting. If you've ever used cloth diapers, you know they can go really small, they can go medium, and then go to the fully extended for like a toddler, and that's what you would use the large insert for. Even still, I use the medium. You can use it all the way through. You can fold it for a newborn, but I will share all three sizes on the blog. I'll leave a link to the exact blog post in the description box below. All right, I'm gonna start for the medium size by cutting out a rectangle at 12 inches by 5 inches. All right, next I'm just going to round off the corners. This is optional, but it just helps for it to stay nice and trim inside the diaper. And then once you get a shape you're really comfortable with, just repeat, repeat, repeat. So depending on how many you're gonna make, just start cutting out a bunch of this organic hemp cotton fleece. And then you're gonna want to get some layers of the micro fleece as well if you're doing that step. And a great thing about making your own diaper inserts is you can also customize it. So let's say you have a really heavy wetter at night, say you're dealing with a toddler who isn't potty trained yet, or something like that. You could make one that has multiple layers until it gets to that desired thickness that is suitable for your toddler. All right, now that I have some of the layers cut out, I'm gonna show you how to put them together on a serger and then also on a standard sewing machine. So if you have a serger, I'll link the one that I use below. If you're gonna get really into sewing, you wanna start making various things around your home or maybe some clothing for your little one, a serger is a good investment. This one is less than $200. I'll link it in the description box below so you can get a decent, nice serger for that price. So it's really only necessary if you plan to make a lot of things. If you're just gonna whip up some cloth diaper covers, obviously I would not recommend getting one. Now the advantage of this is that it will just finish off the edges really, really nicely. All you gotta do is go around all three layers. With the serger, it'll trim off any fabric where you maybe were a little bit uneven. The key is just to make sure that at all times, you are catching all three layers. See how it just gives it that nice finished edge all the way around? And you can see how it would be so easy to make all that you need in your stash really quickly in one afternoon. All you do, cut out the three layers, serger on the outside edge. All right, now let's move over and I'll show you the sewing machine version. All right, now on the sewing machine version, again, I'm gonna do the three layers. This time I'm gonna do a two-step process. So first, I'm just gonna put the layers underneath the presser foot, and I'm gonna sew all the way around the outside edge, about a quarter inch away from the edge here, making sure to capture all three layers or however many layers you decide to do. Now, of course, you can pin this together if you're a brand new sewer and you're not comfortable just putting it together and sewing around the outsides. Pins will help. Make sure to back and forward stitch at the beginning and end. Now see where the serger would have cut off any excess fabric. The sewing machine does not. So I'm just gonna use my scissors to cut off any of that and make sure that it's nice and even all the way around. Okay, next I'm going to bring it back to my machine and I'm gonna finish off those edges with a zigzag stitch. So if you have the inexpensive Brother machine that I recommend, I'll link it below. You can get one for less than $100 and make all of the sewing projects on my blog. You don't have to have a serger. You can get into the hobby for less than $100. Simply go to the zigzag stitch. Now this will not finish off the edges as much as a serger does, but it definitely does the job. Now I'm just gonna go all the way around the outside edge with my zigzag stitch. And you'll see here that the edge is nicely finished off after you've gone all the way around with the zigzag stitch. All right, and that's all there is to it. That's all there is to making your own homemade diaper inserts. Now, if you make all of these with the two layers of the absorbent material and then the micro fleece on top, another option is to double them up. So sometimes I will sandwich two together and put them on top of my diaper cover, and that will work for overnight so that I can just use one during the day and then double the absorbency at night without sewing them together and designating night ones and day ones. I can just sandwich them together, which works perfectly. Now, usually if I do that, I will put it back to back with the absorbent material and then have the micro fleeces on the outside. That way all of the absorbent material is together on the inside. It just seems to me like it would get everything in there better. That's just my experience. If you want the dimensions for the small and large, it's all in the blog post, as well as the detailed instructions and a pinnable graphic. If you are, say, in your first trimester or you're just planning to make this in the future, not right now. You can save it to your baby essentials Pinterest board and any projects that you're hoping to make for your baby, you can save in there. Also, if you're brand new to sewing, make sure to check out my Simple Sewing series. It's on my blog. I know I've mentioned this a lot if you watch all my videos, but I have a free sewing course. It's just a page at farmhouseonmoon.com. If you click on Learn to Sew in the main navigation, it will bring you to everything from threading the machine to creating a hem. It has everything so that you can go from not knowing how to sew to sewing things for your own home. I do have some kids' clothing in there. I haven't done a whole lot of baby tutorials, but if this little one is a girl, I think I'll be a little more motivated. I have a lot of dress tutorials for my older girls, but that was 8 years ago that I had a baby girl. I had 3 boys in a row. So if this little one's a girl, you can bet I'm gonna have so much fun making little clothes. Now I know you can make boys' clothes. I've done it. It's just not as fun, I have to admit, but it's just not as fun. So maybe if it's a boy, I'll just have to make some cute little muslin rompers or something. Stay tuned for that. If you're brand new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. I make 2 new videos every week on food from scratch, natural living, and a handmade home. Also, in the description box below, I'll have the links to my fabric sources so you can make some cloth diaper inserts for your little one. All right, thank you so much for stopping by the farmhouse.